Hey guys, it's Sally Winchell, Wellness Director at Brightside Opportunity Center, coming to you live today on this Friday, rainy Friday, May 22nd. So hopefully, because it's raining, that you will join me for a great low-impact workout today. Not a lot of weights, just kind of a space if you have fives available, or ones, twos, threes, fours, or whatever. Small weights. We're going to just get that heart rate up. We did a lot of strength this week. We did a lot of good conditioning, seated and otherwise. So it's time to get that heart rate up to end this week. Oh my gosh. Hope you're all doing well. What I've been cooking and making a lot of new recipes. So I have one to share with you. And I'm going to, if you want to go quick, grab a pen. It's a new salad dressing that I'm really enjoying. You can write it down. However, I am going to post it on the MindBody email. So if you are in MindBody and you're getting those emails from me, I'm going to post this recipe probably this today or this weekend. It's a pomegranate vinaigrette, and it is really, really good. I can't even remember where I got it from, but I'm going to tell you what it is. Hey, Kate. Hi, Clara. How are you? Aw, hope you're doing good. We're all doing good here. Just enjoying that the week is kind of over and ready to kind of delve into a weekend of cleaning. I'm going to clean my house again and get at some of the projects that I've been kind of putting off. So let's see. Pomegranate vinaigrette dressing. Pomegranate poppy seed. If you have a pen and a paper available, it's a couple ingredients and it's really yummy. I'm going to tell you what it is right now. So go grab your pen. But I will post it. I'll post it as well. So pomegranate vinaigrette poppy seed. A third cup extra virgin olive oil. So I hope I'm not boring you. But a third cup, I use Bragg's extra virgin olive oil. Hi, Rebecca. Hi, Diane. A third cup of pomegranate juice, palm juice, P-O-M. Can you see that? Palm juice. It's usually near the produce section. It is 100% palm juice. It's basically high in sugar, but you're only using a little bit of it. So, hi, Jody and Don. Oh, goody. I'm glad you're ready. So, palm juice. A quarter cup red wine vinegar. 1 to 2 tablespoons. I use maple syrup. You can use honey. I keep the sugar down as much as possible on that because this is basically high sugar. So you can add the honey or the maple syrup if you want. 2 teaspoons Dijon mustard. 1 teaspoon poppy seeds, optional. Hi, Eileen. And a pinch of salt and pepper if you like. So let me go over that again. 1/3 cup extra virgin olive oil. Bragg's is the best. 1/3 cup pomegranate juice. 1/4 cup red wine vinegar. 1 to 2 tablespoons honey or maple syrup. 2 teaspoons Dijon mustard. 1 teaspoon of poppy seeds. Salt and pepper. And I think you're going to love it. I love vinaigrette dressings because they're a little bit lighter than creamy. And we're eating a ton of salads. Salad is the thing of the week. It's actually the thing of all the time. Every night there's a big salad with kale and spinach, and I use tomato, mushrooms, all kind of goodies, and then I'm experimenting with some new dressings. So this is one you're going to really like. If your email is with me on the MindBody website, which is where I have all of our members, I'm going to post this as my next shout out, my next mass email. So the pomegranate vinaigrette. Anyway, hi Maria, hi Sharon, hi Ruby, hey Marilyn, good to hear from you guys. Hi Diana, thanks for checking in today on this rainy Friday. We can keep this as a low impact, or if you want to make it a little bit more intense, add weight, have some hand weights available. Not everything has weights, so you don't need any space. I mean, you don't need space. You do need space. You do not need really anything else for it. So we're going to get going. Let me put my pomegranate juice away, and we're going to get started with the workout. So put that down. Okay, the warm-up. I'll put a little music on. We've done this workout before, but I really, really like it. So we're going to do it again. You make it work for you. If you don't have your knees feeling 100% today, or something's not feeling great, go very, very minimal on your range of motion and keep it simple. But the first three exercises that we will do are simply a warm-up. So let's get going. Hi, Denise. Aloha. Terry. Hi, Terry. How are your knees today, Terry? On this rainy day. Oh, man. I know I'm feeling it, too. I am feeling it. Okay, so here we go. Get into your space. And let me start that one in the beginning. All right, guys. Let's get busy. Put that heel out in front of your body. Step a little bit closer. Bring your arms up. Now, hinge forward, and as you do that, take your arms back and around and scoop them up and around. Remember this one? This is such a great warm-up for the entire body. It starts to engage glutes, hamstrings, shoulders, and we're going nice and easy. I'm a little bit sore today. You can even do it to here if that works for you. Swing those arms around just like that. If you start to get nice and warm, you can just go a little deeper into that hinge. Take it around. Let's do two more on this side. One, and there is two. Coming back up, take your other foot, put that heel forward, heel and your toe is up. Bring those arms up. Now as you hinge forward, take your arms back and around. This one's not going to be warm yet. And warm it up. That's it. Make sure you're working just to what's working for you today. Couple more. Good. Swinging those arms. Let's go a little deeper on this one now. We're starting to get warm. Just hinge a little bit farther forward. Good. I think three more. There's one. There's two. This is a nice slow warm up. It's not really meant to get that heart rate up. It's meant to warm the body up, get your body ready for exercise. We're going to send those hips back a little bit in our 45 degree angle. Take your arms out to the side. Thumbs are up. Do you remember this one? I got to make sure I'm in the picture. Bring your arms down and up. Down and up. I'm going to keep my head down a little bit. Keeping that spine nice and neutral. Bring it up. Getting again that upper body nice and warm. Bring it up into a lateral position. That means to the sides. Let's do three more. There's one, two, three. Now take your hands forward. You're staying in that position in the 45. And you're just keeping your arms going straight forward. Thumbs up. Keep your spine nice and neutral as you're doing this. If your back gets a little tired, stand up, rest it, and go right back into it. Now let's go into the letter Y. So they're going to the side slightly, kind of in between, lateral and forward. We're going to call this four. I'm going to go to 10 on this. Five. Keep it going. Six. This is our little bit of a warm up. Seven. Three more. Eight. Two more. Nine. One more. And 10. As you come up, roll up slowly. Don't go really super fast. Now, we're going to just march in place. Not fast. Pick up those knees. Bend the elbows or keep the arms pumping. with the legs. That's it. Stepping, a little bit of a balance here because we're going slow. When you go slow, it's you're learning, your body's adjusting to balance. Yep. I did promise you some biceps and triceps today, besides the low impact. I'm not sure if we're going to do that or not. It's going to depend on how we are doing by the end of this workout. If I feel like it's something I want to throw in. Just a couple more marches. This is our warm up. A couple more. Pick up those legs. That gets those lower abs engaged. And stop. Before we start, if you need a drink, grab a drink of water. Hi, Shelly. Jean, James, yes. Good crowd today for a rainy Friday. Here's my water. I'm gonna ask you to get one dumbbell, either a 1 through a 5, no higher than a 5. And you will remember this. We're gonna take one arm up and the opposite leg. So you're just lifting and coming back down. Go ahead with it. Your knees are not locked. Your standing leg has a kind of a little slight bend in it. 4, 5, 6. Let's go 15 on this. Definitely balance here. 7, 8, 9. I'm working this shoulder. 10. Working that hip, 11, and balance, 12. Three more, 13. We'll feel really good after this. 14, one more, here we go. And 15, switch sides, put that dumbbell in your other hand. We're gonna take that arm up and your opposite leg out. 1, woo, here we go with the balance. 2, it doesn't have to go super high with the leg. 3, again, we're still in the early stages here. 4, so we are getting warmed up. 5, 6, there we go. 7, 8, yes. 9, good work. Let's go 15, 10, let's keep that as kind of our rep range today. 16, I'm losing it. I don't know where I'm at, Judy. Oh, Judy's not even on today. Let's do 2 more. I'm gonna try to talk, instruct, and do the exercises. Good, there we go. Bent over, alternating raises. Grab your other weight if you wanna have higher intensity. All right, bending over means hips go back. This is bent over. It's not this where you're hanging forward. You wanna set those hips back into a 45. Go as deep as you want. Arms are going up. So it's an anterior raise in a bent over position, which again is great for low back strength, alternating arms, alternating just to shoulder level. They don't need to go any higher than shoulder level. Bring them up. Make sure you're always breathing. Never hold your breath when you're exercising. It's not good for you to hold your breath. Now remember, this is cardio, so we can't just do 5 reps or, you know, even 10. The best thing to do is do about at least 20 seconds to 30 seconds of each exercise. All right, I'm gonna do 3 more on each side. 1, 2, come on guys, you got this. And there's your 3, put those weights down. We don't need it for the next exercise. All right, functional. We're gonna go into a split stance. So 1 foot in front of the other, it's kind of a, you can call this a lunge. And all you're gonna do is bend that back knee and down and up. So you're just reaching forward or reaching down. If you want to go deep, you can even go a little bit deeper. Now this is one that if your knees are cranky, you probably won't like, but you want to make sure that front knee is lining up with that toe. Just do your best. Just do your best, guys. Like you were reaching down to pick something up. Yeah, oh boy, am I feeling that right there? In my back of my leg. It's a great, great workout. Now let's switch stance. I'm gonna just kind of switch sides here. Make sure you're switching your legs. And here we go. If it's just a little bend like this, that is great. Just dipping down with that back knee, bending toward the floor, whatever you're comfortable with. I might go a little bit deeper and bend a little bit at the waist. That's it. There we go. Split squat. Good work, everybody. Keep smiling. It makes it better when you smile, right? At least we're looking like we're having a good time, even though we're probably hating it. Five more reps. Here we go. One. Two. Oh yeah, this is great work. Three. Two more. Come on. Four. Stay with it. One more. Five. Excellent. Toe touches or knee touches. Star. Here's my star. I'm going to take my opposite hand and touch your inside of your knee, alternating. That would be modified. Or touch toes. Keep going. Whatever it is that you're doing, whatever works for you today. Why am I so nice today, huh? Am I nice today? I'm usually not this nice. Woo, keep going. Keep going. Toe touches. Knees are not locked. Slight bend in the knee. Keep it going. Remember, if you can just touch the inside of your knee, that works for me as well. Here we go. Thank God it's Friday. Yes. Couple more. One. Five more. Two. Three. Four. And five. Good job. Now, if you have a wall handy, go to your wall. We're going to do 20 push-ups. If you want to go on the floor, go on the floor. Well, you know what? I can go right here at my fireplace, and I can do a wall push-up. So you're going to find your spot, put your hands at the wall, you're up on your tippy toes, and send your body forward, push back so it's ballistic, or not. Three, four, I'm going to push back, five, six, seven, I can't see you, I bet you better be doing it, eight, nine, 20 reps, 10, push off, 11, 12, 13, I like these, 14, 5 more, 16, 17, 18, woo, 19, and there's your 20. I trust you did those. I couldn't watch you, but I trust you did those. Hey, Rebecca says, oh, I'm your exercise mom. I do know what's good for you. Thanks, Rebecca. Okay, now we're gonna pretend that we're jumping rope, and if it's just lifting those heels up off the floor, that's fine. I'm going to pick up my weight and pretend I'm jumping rope. So I'm going to hold weight, circle my hands. Again, you can just lift your heels up. You can just do little bounces. Pick your heels up. Whatever it is you're doing is totally fine. We're jumping rope. Our favorite thing, jumping. Knocked. Woo! I do know what's good for you. I do, I promise. I would not steer you wrong. Okay, I'm not done yet. Talk about getting the heart rate up. Jumping rope, woo, is one of the best exercises for conditioning, cardio. Don't stop. Don't stop. Jump rope. Oh boy. Oh boy. 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. That was actually 20 for me. Woo, yeah. Those calves are going to need a... Jody did it. Thanks, Jody. Good job. All right. Butt kicks with arm cross, which means just bringing those, see, I'm out of breath. This will bring it down a bit. Cross arms and kick your butt. Send that knee back. Oh, yeah. Whew. You got this, guys. You're doing a good job. You know how I love cardio. Not. I like to pick heavy things up and put them back down. That's my favorite type of exercising. I like heavy lifting. Get a good burn on that. Burns calories like crazy. Stay with it, come on. Stay with it. Stay with it. Woo, yeah. Okay, a couple more. And stop. Good time to get a drink. We're probably about halfway through, maybe a little bit more. I forgot one, we gotta go back. All right, we're doing little kicks in the front. And you're gonna, when you kick, pull your arms back. So kick, kick, get into it, kick. I don't know if I'm coordinated enough for this. When you kick, your arms come back. So arms are forward, here, here, here. There we go. Kick, pull those arms back, get that work done across that chest. Kick higher, kick higher. There we go. Get them up there. Get those legs up. Get those legs up. Yes. Woo. I see ya. Oh, what did I hit my elbow with my watch? Kick it up. Kick it up. Come on. Don't stop. Come on. I'm getting like a Nazi here. The exercise Nazi. Woo! 5 more. 1, 2, 3, 4. And whatever that is, wow, 5, that got it going on. All right, let's stop the legs. Let's do dumbbell swings through the legs. So I'm gonna take one dumbbell, it's kinda like a kettlebell swing, kind of, not really, but hold that dumbbell in both hands. You're gonna do a little mini squat and send it up over your head. Mini squat up over your head. Whew. Remember what the purpose of this workout today is: heart rate up. If you know that your heart rate is too high, if you're not monitoring it, if you can't talk or if you're gasping for breath, that's too high, then you stop Bring it down slowly. I'm okay because I can talk to you at the same time as I'm doing the work. Now I would know if it was too much. You gotta listen to your body. Always listen to that body. Come on. One, five reps. You know that. Two, whew, three, two more. Come on. Four, one more. And five. Ah, yes. Okay, now, take both dumbbells, or not, and we're gonna do forward. You're gonna run forward, forward, back, back. So you're just little forward, forward, back, back. Now here's the kicker. You gotta hold your arms up in the air while you're doing that. So if you have weight or not, that's what we're gonna do. So get those arms up and we're gonna run forward, forward, back, back. I started with my right foot. Whew. Again, remember, when you get arms and legs at the same time, it ups the intensity. Forward, forward, back, back. Now stop and do it with the other way. I'm gonna start with my left foot now, just to get that switch up in there. Forward, forward, back, back. Whew. Good job. Good job, everybody. We're sweating today. Sweating to the oldies. Don't stop. If you get tired with the arms, just keep doing the feet. Forward, forward, back, back. That's it. Whew. And stop. Put your weights, you can put your weights away or not. But what I'm gonna do is keep them, because we're gonna do hook punches where we have them here and we're just punching with a bent arm. Hook punches, so the legs are kind of quiet now. You're just a little tiny quarter, not even maybe a quarter squat, and you're just punching, punch, punch. Yes. Punching. That's it. Punch. Yes. Burning the cows off today. I get my treat on Saturday night. I get a treat this week. Whoo, yeah. Good. Couple more. Come on. Do your best. If it doesn't challenge you, it doesn't change you. Whoa. Okay, I'm gonna grab a drink. Good time to get a drink. We're gonna do kickbacks, tricep kickbacks, with a reverse lunge or simply a step back, okay? Do you remember this? Your hands are up here like you're gonna do a kickback, right? Now, if you just wanna step back, put your foot back, go for it. So foot is alternating back, or go into a reverse lunge, which is what I'm doing right now. That's it. Whew. Reverse lunge with tricep kickback. Whoa, I lost my balance. Remember, you can just step back. My rug's moving around. I'm gonna go this way now for a little bit. We're almost done. We've got three more. Good. Three more things. I like this. All right, then stop. Okay, I'm gonna set those down. We're gonna do a squat press. So you know this one. I'm gonna grab my weight. And what we're going to do, what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my dumbbells right here. And it can be little squat and press. Little squat and press. Go ahead. Come on, join me now. Whew. Squat, press. Oh, I like this one. These are called combination or compound exercises that you get multiple body parts in one exercise. Squat and press. This is hard now. Three. Let's finish up with 10. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Woo, one more. And 10. Oh boy. Two more, guys. Two more. Put the dumbbells down. We're going to do a squat pulse with no weight. We're just going to go into that position and pulse. Burn those quads out. Burn those quads. Here we go. Woo, yeah. It's warm in my house. Here we go. Just little pulses with your butt. Feel that burn starting. Don't fall on the floor. If you can't handle it, stand up, shake it out. Go right back into it. Oh. I'm feeling this. Oh yeah. Oh my gosh. Ah, come up. Oh my goodness gracious. Oh my gosh, we got one more, guys. I'm going to pick those weights back up. We're going to do hot feet, like on the balls of your feet, on your toes, and we're going to curl while we do hot feet. All right? This is your last one. So you can do this. You can do this, guys. Come on. So don't worry about the music. I'm just doing hot feet and curling, so I'm getting those biceps. And kind of the cool thing about this is today, not only did we get cardio, we worked shoulders, biceps, triceps, abs, chest with our push-ups. It's so good. We're finishing strong. Finish strong. Yes. TGIF. It's good stuff. Oh. I'm hanging in there. I'm hanging in there. We're going to cool it down once we're done with these. Hot feet, hot feet. Whew. Yes. Oh, I know what you're thinking. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, she is crazy. And make it stop. And I'm stopping. All right. Woo. Ah, grab a drink. Ooh, better one Tootsie Roll. I went off for a little bit. Ah, hey Kiki. Oh my goodness. Love you guys. All right, now we're going to do a cool down, standing cool down, just to recover from all of that. What music do we like here? Something nice and slow. Alrighty. Alright, put that heel out. Now all we're going to do is stretch and kind of hinge forward like that. And come back. Actually, you know what? I take that back. Stay down there. It's called a good morning. And you feel that stretch in that hamstring. I'm not doing anything. I'm not reaching. Hi, Ann. Feel that stretch as you hinge forward and you have that one leg out. Hold it. static stretch. When you're not moving the stretch, switch. Put that heel forward and hinge forward. Leading again with that heart. Don't round your upper back and feel the stretch in your hamstring in that leg. You can rest your hands right here on the tops of your thighs or at your hips. Oh, that's a good one. That's a great one. All right, chest stretch. Hands behind your head. Take your elbows and pull them back so you feel a stretch right through the top of your chest. Oh, this is good today. I liked it. Release it. Do it again. Pull those elbows back. Feel that stretch. Whole new world. Feel that stretch. Just reach up with both arms. Just reach and pull, like pulling out of your shoulder. So just don't shrug, but just reach like you want to touch that ceiling without shrugging your shoulders, and pull and just let it relax. Again, reach and look up. Make sure you're breathing. Let's do one more. Stretch and reach. Bring your arms down. All right. Shoulder rotation. This is one of my new favorites, where we rotate forward and then back up again. This is so healthy for those shoulders, rotator cuff muscles. Rotate forward. That's great. That is good. Now, I do want to stretch those quads. All right, so let's do one more. Shoulder rotation forward, like so. All right, bring them down. Now, if you want to hold on to a chair or something, a wall, whatever you've got, I'm going to get my chair out. And we're going to stretch that quad. Okay, like that. Pull that toe or pull that heel towards your butt. And you'll feel that nice stretch in the front of your quad. We really worked them today. Really worked them good. All right, and then switch sides. I don't have my back to you, so I'll turn this over here. Stretch that quad. We'll say byes and tries for Monday. I'm sorry, Tuesday at 3. We don't want to neglect them. I mean, to really do a good bicep and tricep superset, where we're going to do multiple exercises for the same muscle group. There we go. Whew. All right, let's do a plie. Bring your arms cross or your wrists cross, wide legs on this. Squat down. Now, as you come up, bring your arms and sweep them up, crossing over, breathing in, opening and blowing out. Let's do one more. And you are done. Wow. That was awesome, guys. That was a good one. That was a really good one. Terry says, thanks for not making us get down on the floor today. You are welcome, Terry. I thought about it. I was thinking push-ups on the floor, and then I changed my mind. So I'm going to post that pomegranate vinaigrette. I'm actually not going to post it. I'm going to put it in the email to everybody that has their email address in MindBody. I'm going to start posting some recipes in there so we can hit all of our members. And what else? I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend and just get out and have some fun. Hopefully the sun's going to shine. I love you all. You're my superstars again. And peace out.